Good day mga kahabi. So one day after this koi fry was hatched. So even though some of them started to hatch at around 30 hours since they were spawned. So in my counting, I started always to count the number of days of fry after 48 hours. So today, 24 hours after they were hatched, so that is one day. And then as you can see, we can really see them already even in the camera. So there are really plenty of them. And then for the sake of this video, so that we can clearly see the koi fry, I temporarily turn off the air pump. So we'll turn it on so you can see the amount of oxygen that we provided to our koi fry. Then supposed to be we'll be giving them their first food, which is live food today, but unfortunately it rained again and then we're not able to get live food. But since it's 24 hours since they were hatched, they're still consuming their yolk sac, but some of them are starting to eat already. That's why we've given them a small amount of this powder food. So this is a fry booster, or in your, or depending on the breeder, you can use regular pellet food and then you crush it into powder. So that are some of your option. And then the reason why I'm not giving them with egg yolk, that is because not all of them are or were able to eat. So there's a tendency that there will be some of the egg yolk will not be eaten, which will contaminate the water. So tomorrow, so 48 hours since they were hatched, we can then feed them with egg yolk. So even with aeration, they are already very visible. One reason of that, because of our this forgot the name of this. So the possible variety of this koi fry is ginrin kuhako, ginrin sangke, ginrin showa. So different variety of ginrin, because our female is I ginrin kuhako, and then we have one of the male, which is hishowa, and then two sangke. So we will really get plenty of variety from this breeding. And then we can see already also, based on the color of the fry, that we will be getting Matsuri variety. For me, this breeding is really hard because as of now we really have a limited supply of live food, or the available live food in the wild. And then we just have to use our usual technique, which will we show to you in the coming videos as to what will be the food that we will give to them. So the alternative food. But if you compare that to live food, so live food is really incomparable. And then I just want to emphasize also that we will grow this koi fry in here, so we will not put them into the mud pond, because we do, as of now we don't have a mud pond, so this is a backyard breeding and then growing only, which is good also because we can control our environment and then maintain water quality compared to mud pond, that there are really lots of bacteria which is harmful to the fish, and then it's hard to really quarantine them after harvest. So we have tried that, or we have an experience of that before, but since it is rainy day already, and then flood also is common to the mud pond. So based on my estimation, this will reach up to 20,000, 15 to 20,000 koi fry currently, and then depending on how we grow them, that number will surely decrease. First factor is cannibalism, and then second is that which is inevitable. And then we really have to maintain water quality because there are really plenty of them. So again, we are using 25 watts air pump. So this is a compressor. Given that we have a big tank and then plenty of koi fry, so we are really making sure that all the koi fry gets enough oxygen. So the higher the oxygen, the better, because it will help in digestion. And then if they get or they have a good digestion, they really grow fast. I think not much on today's video. We'll just make a daily update so that after 2 months we can make a video documentation on how to breed koi and how to grow them from day zero up to the day that we will release them. So again, if you are new to my channel, please support it by clicking the subscribe button and hit the notification bell, so that you will be notified to my upcoming videos for ideas and suggestion, especially on how to grow this koi fry. Please comment it also below. So thank you, keep safe, and happy fish keeping.